Hi everyone, welcome to today's session. In the previous session, we have learned how the refraction is taking place through a glass prism. Let's have a fast recap of the previous topic. As you can see on the board, ABC is the principal section of a glass prism. AB and AC are the two refracting surfaces being inclined to each other. PQ is the incident ray. It is falling at the surface AB. Since it is traveling from air to glass, it is bending towards the normal, and the refracted ray QR being bent towards the base of the prism. You can see on the board. And when it strikes the surface AC, it is ready to emerge from denser medium to brighter medium. Again, it is bending away from the normal, but you can see the emergent ray is again further bending towards the base of the prism. So whenever the refraction is taking place through a glass prism, the refracted ray and emergent ray bends towards the base of the prism. All right. And AB and AC, the refracting edge surfaces being inclined to each other, the incident ray PQ and the emergent ray are never parallel to each other, so that angle I is not equal to angle E. So when the refraction is taking place through a glass prism, there is a certain angle through which the emergent ray is turning from its original path. That we call it as angle of deviation, denoted by a letter delta. So what is angle of deviation? So angle of deviation is the angle between, as you can see, the angle between the incident ray produced forward and the emergent ray produced backward. Angle TMS is known as angle of deviation. This ray diagram is very important for a board examination point of view. All of you must practice it. Okay. So now in this session, let us study what are the factors affecting angle of deviation and the ID curve. Very important topic. Let us see what are the factors on which angle of deviation depends. The first factor on which delta, the angle of deviation, depends is the refractive index. Let us see how the refractive index affects the angle of deviation produced. It has been experimentally found that the angle of deviation increases with refractive index mu. More the refractive index, greater is the angle of deviation produced. So I can write delta directly proportional to mu, the refractive index of material of a glass prism. It means that more thickly or more densely the molecules of the glass is packed, more will be the refractive index and more will be the angle of deviations. Okay. For example, a flint glass prism produces more deviation than a crown glass prism because for the same refracting angle, because the refractive index of flint glass is more than that of refractive index of crown glass. So though both are glass, refractive index of flint glass is more than that of refractive index of crown glass. So obviously refractive index of flint glass will produce more deviation. Clear? So this is the first factor. Now let us check what is the influence of angle of deviation on angle of deviation, or angle of the prism on angle of deviation. First, second is angle of prism. Angle of prism A. Okay. So it is also found that as the angle of deviation delta increases with increase in angle of the prism. So I can write delta is directly proportional to angle of the prism. Alright. So as the angle of the prism increases, angle of deviation is also going on increasing. Please remember, because there is an equation given by delta is equal to mu minus 1 into A. There is an equation. Angle of deviation is equal to. So the quantity in the bracket for a given prism is constant. So obviously I can write delta directly proportional to angle of the prism. Okay, please remember this factor. Now the third factor on which angle of deviation delta depend is color or wavelength. Color or wavelength of the light. As you know, the refractive index of a given transparent medium is different for the different colors or different wavelength. So you know, you have studied in the previous session, the refractive index decreases with increase in wavelength. So I can write mu is inversely proportional to the wavelength lambda. The more the wavelength, more will be more the wavelength, lesser will be the refractive index. You know that wavelength of red is more than that of violet, so I can write that refractive index for violet is greater than refractive index of red. All right, so violet light will experience more refractive index than that of red light. So the deviation produced will be, so the angle of deviation for violet will be greater than angle of deviation produced by red. Obviously we can write. All right, okay, so remember that for a given prism, for visible light, the deviation is maximum for violet color and minimum for red color, because refractive index of violet is more than that of refractive index of red. Moreover, refractive index is directly inversely proportional to lambda. Is it clear? Yes. This is the third factor. Now, the fourth factor on which the angle of deviation delta depend is the angle of incidence. Angle of incidence I. Okay, let us study how the angle of incidence affects the angle of deviation. It is experimentally observed that as the angle of incidence increases, the angle of deviation first decreases, and then further increasing the angle of incidence, the angle of deviation begins to increase. This is the observation. Let us try to place this in an ID curve or I delta curve, where in an ID curve, angle of incident is taken on x-axis and delta is taken on y-axis. All right, this is ID curve or I delta curve. Okay, very important for the board examination. So as per our observation, let us place this observation in a graph and see. It is observed that as the angle of incidence increases, the angle of deviation decreases. So as the angle of incidence increases, angle of deviation decreases, and it reaches to a minimum value, and further a particular angle of incidence, if you increase the angle of incidence further, what happens? The angle of deviation increases. Okay, so this is ID curve. Once again I will explain. As the angle of incidence increases, the angle of deviation going on decreasing, you can see that the angle of deviation going on decreasing delta, and it reaches to a minimum value. Beyond that value, if you increase the angle of incidence, the angle of deviation increases. All right, so and this is the minimum value of angle of deviation. I call it as angle of minimum deviation. So this is the particular position of angle of prism with respect to the incident ray, at which the incident ray suffers minimum deviation. This is called a, so at this position the incident ray suffers minimum deviation. This particular position I call it as angle of minimum deviation, delta minimum. At delta minimum, it is observed that the incident ray and the emergent ray are parallel to each other. At that case, angle I is equal to angle E. So at a minimum deviation position, I can say that this is a particular position, only at this position the incident ray and emergent ray are parallel to each other, and the refracted ray being exactly parallel to the base of the prism. All right, you can see that at a minimum deviation position, angle I will be equal to angle E. The refracted ray PQRS, the refracted ray QR being parallel to the base of the prism BC, and in this case angle I will be equal to angle E. All right, so this is the minimum deviation position. So at minimum deviation position, angle I will be equal to angle E, and when angle I is equal to angle E, incident ray and emergent ray is parallel to each other, and the refracted ray inside the prism is always parallel to the each other at a minimum deviation position. All right, okay, please remember this point. and this is ID curve. So ID curve is clear to you. So as the angle of incidence increases, angle of deviation decreases at a particular point, and further if you increase the angle of incidence, again the angle of deviation going on increasing, and the minimum value at which the incident ray suffers minimum deviation, I call it as delta minimum. So please remember all this point, the factors affecting the angle of deviation and ID curve. All right, okay. Now let's discuss few board questions related to this particular topic, today's topic. The first question, it is asked in 2009. How does the value of angle of deviation produced by a prism change with increase in value of angle of incidence? So we have already discussed the case. In case of ID curve, as the angle of incidence increases, the angle of deviation going on decreases till a particular value. Beyond this particular value, if you increase the angle of incidence, the angle of deviation increases. And this particular value, we call it as delta minimum. Already we have discussed. So this is how the value of angle of deviation depends on angle of incidence. The second question, the wavelength of incident light. So we have already studied that when the wavelength of the light increases, angle of deviation decreases. So I can say that delta is inversely proportional to the wavelength. The more the wavelength, lesser will be the deviation. Or lesser the wavelength, more will be the deviation. So this is a 2-mark question. Or if you write the answer briefly, you will get 2 marks. All right? Okay. Now the second question, you can see a glass prism. The question is asked in 2008. You can see in a given prism shows a ray of light incident on an equilateral glass prism in minimum deviation position. It is at a minimum deviation position. Okay, so remember this particular position of the prism. Okay, so at a minimum deviation position, what happens? Let PQ be the incident ray. The refracted ray is always parallel to the base of the prism. QR is the incident ray. So QR is the refracted ray. So at a minimum deviation position, QR is always parallel to base of the prism BC. Remember that. Then it emerges out. All right? Yes. We have to copy this diagram and we have to complete the path of refracted ray and the emergent ray. So draw a normal angle of incidence. If there was no glass slab, light ray would have passed in a straight line. Again, draw a normal to the point of R, and this is angle of emergence. Produce the emergent ray backward, and this angle you get it as angle of deviation, angle M, the angle between the emergent ray produced backward and the incident ray produced forward. All right, so the, and this is the angle of refraction. So the diagram is completed. So you will get 1 mark after completing the whole diagram. Don't forget to add the arrow mark here. All right, so which shows the direction of light. The second part is how are the angle of incident and angle of emergence related to each other in this particular position. So you know that at minimum deviation position, angle I will be always equal to angle E. That's all. You'll get one more mark. So total 2 marks. So these are the types of board questions which are asked in the previous years. Practice all those questions, and more importantly, understand how the refraction is taking place. Understand the concept. Don't mug up the things. All right? Okay. Thank you very much.